We just left the Coast Guard station in Newcastle, and we're on a small boat right now on our way to the Tahoma. It's about 6 miles out to sea, and we're told it'll take 15 minutes or so to get out there. We are in our full-body suits. That'll keep us a little bit warmer if we were to fall into the water. It'll also keep us afloat.
The American flag led the way as our six-person crew raced us out to the Tahoma at 25 knots. On board are 100 crew members who have been out at sea for 5 weeks. This was a patrol mission. Rescues are possible at any time.
That's what makes this job exciting. You're always doing something completely different.
Gunner's Mate First Class Aaron O'Brien is in charge of all the weapons on board.
It's pretty exciting. It's a lot of responsibility.
Including the gigantic 76-millimeter cannon up front. It shoots an intimidating 80 rounds a minute. Just as intimidating is the climb down to the engine room, an area normally off limits to cameras. Here, two 18-cylinder train engines power everything on board. Engineers monitor for problems around the clock. Meals are also served around the clock, and the crew says the food is actually good. The living area is tight, one locker for each person, and a bed that's hard to crawl into and impossible to roll over in. Not that there's much sleeping done.
So it works.
Scattered thunderstorms.
Meetings are regular. This one is to plan today's trip home. It took Lieutenant John McDonald 3 days to coordinate.
How do you learn to do all of that?
It's on the job. On the job, very much so.
Home port on three, home port on three. One, two, three.
Home port!
There's time for one last meeting as we near the shipyard. Approaching the dock, the crew can see their families waiting. And after 5 weeks, that's a welcome sign.
There's no better feeling in the world, I think, just to come home.
Well, the Tahoma is now back here at the shipyard. The crew of about 100 will have the next 2 days off before they have to come back for five-day-a-week shifts as the ship stays here for the next 7 weeks. They call that in port. And after that, they'll be off on their next mission. At the Portsmouth Naval Shipyard, I'm Josh Davis, WMUR News 9.